backstage.
I've met Billy Joel, I've met Owen John, and I've now met Dave Watts.
Really, mate.
A Sparky Ninja. Yeah? So we've been joined today by Sparky Ninja. It's an honour to be standing this close to such a god amongst the YouTube community and especially the electrical industry. And we're looking today at the Linear products. Linear fire clips is something I've been actively following for some time. And we really like their products for supporting mineral insulated and FP200s. However, David, we've stumbled across today.
Well, we've gone through a couple of questions and we've taken the time to find a solution to fixing twin and CPC cables, and Linian have now got that here, demonstration there. So we have twin and CPC surface clips on timbers. We have a solution much better than the previous cable types we have, and we've also got down below still our armor cabling, and they've got increased thickness to tolerate the mechanical strength with bending of the radius of the armor, so it's a lot more stronger for the support for the cable type. And they've also now got supports for plastic conduit systems, so this is something that we've been looking for to expand the variety. Now they are also producing some more types of systems, which is a bit secret, and we're going to hopefully get some new information on that towards Christmas time.
So we've got these super clips and we really like them. We're all responsible for premature collapsing under the 18th edition wiring regulations in every location. And we think Linear are at the forefront of new innovation, especially as they're the first people we've seen supporting twin and CPC.
It's the first engineering solution that I've seen. And it's good because it's answering a question that I've been asked a lot. And now I can just find a place people to go with.
It's fantastic.
Great stuff.
Thank you to Linear.
Cheers.
It's Plymouth Sparky. We've had Sparky Ninja, now we've got Plymouth Sparky, and of course we've got Richard Townsend, the creator of the Code Breaker. And we're on edition number 2, is that correct?
Yeah, edition number 2 for the 18th edition. All rewritten, double the content, double the codes, lots more information for contractors, recovering, arc fault detection, all sorts of everything.
David, is there anything you'd like to see in that book?
Yeah, Richard, I'd want to know if there's any additional information on SPDs.
Yes, there's a section on surface protection, what to look for if you're doing the ICR, what to code things if you find them or you don't find them, the risk assessment for the combined risk length. We go all through that and give you some dummy examples so you can understand whether we need to use surface protection or not on an installation.
So it's evolved, we would suggest. We've just seen the presentation, haven't we? I think we did quite well on our C1, C2s and C3.
Good, yeah.
Yeah, not too bad. One or two hecklers, I think, in the audience. But we've evolved that book. It's a lot bigger, and now it's got additional information to help make electricians' life easier.
Yeah.
I thought the first edition was fantastic. I've had a little look at the draft, and it looks fantastic as well. So I'm here with Senior Engineer Stephen from the IET, and he's wrote a fantastic book to help us understand the wiring regulations from a student's perspective. Can you tell us a little bit about that book, Stephen?
Yeah, of course. Well, prior to joining the IET, I was a lecturer at Cambridge Regional College, and I found resources for students were kind of far and few between. So when I joined IET, I took the opportunity to put together the student's guide, which basically compiled all the information that I struggled to find in one place when I was lecturing, and put into nice, understandable, bite-sized pieces of information, lots of illustrations and nice sort of layman descriptions to help students that are just starting out in the industry.
It is a fantastic book. I know we say you've got to buy a couple of books on our course, but this is one of the books that we say coming towards December that they should be buying. It's a fantastic guide, even just simple things like Ohm's Law all the way through, as well as the wiring regulation. So it's a college book as much as a wiring regulation book.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. So really pleased with it, and had a lot of great feedback from students and lecturers, and it's widely used as a teaching resource in the colleges that I've visited.
And more than half our learners bought it last year. So thank you very much, Stephen.
No problem.
Cheers,
thank you. Cheers.
So I'm with Jeff, Chief Electrical Engineer at the IET, and he's going to give us a quick overview of some of the changes in the 18th edition. Jeff.
Hi, yeah, I'm Secretary of the National Wiring Regulations Committee, which is the committee responsible for the 18th edition. And as you say, there are some quite key changes in the 18th edition. Things like Section 722, electric vehicles, no longer allows PME as a means of earthing for electric vehicle unless you meet all the requirements of the wiring regulations. There's three key areas that you'd have to meet. Things like the regulation concerning socket outlets, which is quite a common one, 41133, that's changed slightly. Now it goes up to 32 amps. You have to have RCD protection, 30 milliamp RCD protection. Things like one of the key areas for installation of cables, you now have to protect against premature collapse in the event of a fire throughout the installation, which is a key area, of course, you know.
And we're thinking about 30 minutes for that premature. It's going to be held in place for approximately 30 minutes, would you suggest?
Well, there's no time given, you know, so really it's... the wiring regulations just say premature collapse, so as I say, there's no time given there. There are quite a few other key changes, things like the section 753, which is heating cables and embedded heating, that's been extended now to cover wall heating and other areas.
Okay.
So I don't want to go through every possible detail change, but there are some very key changes in this book.
It's important that we keep up to date with our training in order that we keep up to date with the regulations. Thank you, Jeff.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Cheers.
One day, and what are we going to say, gents? We hope this video has been some help.